Hey guys, Tim here. Today we're going to be ranking every Call of Duty Zombies character from worst to best. I have a few things to say before we get any further. Number one, Treyarch Zombies only. Number two, we're excluding Samantha from Moon and the four Marines from World at War because they're not significant and I don't know their names. And also, I'm not going to be including the Chaos crew, the Black Ops 4 Zombies crew, because we haven't played as them yet, so I really don't have a feel for them. These are playable characters only, and I'm going to be doing this in a unique way. I'm going to rank each crew from worst to best, and then within the crew, I'll rank the characters. So for example, I'll rank the worst crew, then go over those characters, then the second worst, go over them, and that's how it's gonna go. It might be a little bit confusing, but you will get the hang of it as we go. So without further ado, let's jump into it. The worst Zombies crew has to be the Victus crew, which we see on Transit, Dyrise, and Buried, a really dull group of individuals, the worst of which is Marlton Johnson, the self-righteous and arrogant character who is essentially a nerd, and the way we discover him is in a fallout bunker within Nuketown. Marlton overall is just a very irritating character, doesn't have very many impactful quotes. He and Misty develop some sort of weird relationship. They're constantly flirting. I find him to just be very irritating. He's not very in depth. I don't hate him, but I don't enjoy having him as a character. I just happen to think that he is one of the worst characters in the worst crew. At number 23, we have Samuel Stuhlinger, who is just as annoying, but does play a more important role due to his ability to hear Richtofen through Aether. Stuhlinger is definitely the most unique of the four of them because of his ability to hear Richtofen, but it also leads to him being sort of an outcast. He's constantly talking to himself and struggling internally with the voices inside of his head. He likes to blurt out a bunch of random, nonsensical quotes that really just don't make a lot of sense. I just don't enjoy him as a character very much. Very similar to Marlton, except he is older and is slightly more important. At number 22, we have Russman, whose full name is Russman. We don't know much about him. He's not nearly as annoying as the other two I've talked about, but in the same breath, he's not very important, and his character arc is very shallow. He's that stereotypical old wise guy who knows everything, or at least thinks he does. I don't have many complaints about Russman. He's just sort of a meh character. I don't know. I just don't dig him that much. Number 21, Abigail Briarden, aka Misty, the one and only, the one who manages to find herself in every clickbait thumbnail for zombies due to the fact that she has a pair of breasts. Misty talks and talks and talks and talks a little more, and it comes to a point where I just want to mute her. She doesn't have very many intelligent quotes, and quite ironically, she happens to be the funniest and the most badass of these four characters. Once upon a time, people believed that this was the daughter of Tank Dempsey, which still surprises me to this day that anyone believed that, but you know, Misty is a pretty good character. I don't have many complaints about her. The Victus crew overall very dull. They're constantly bickering back and forth. Misty and Marlton have sort of a relationship, and they both hate Russman and Stuhlinger, and Stuhlinger and Russman sort of hate them too, and even Russman and Stuhlinger have these conflicts, you know, back and forth. Like, it's just a group of misfits, really. Overall, they're fairly important to the story, but individually, when you narrow it down to each character, not very good. Now on to the next crew, which is the Call of the Dead cast, a group of celebrities that have been stranded out in a Siberian outpost trying to film, wouldn't you guess it, Call of the Dead, with your boy George Romero, who I'm not going to be including. The worst character in this crew happens to be number 20, Robert Englund, whose most famous role is Freddy Krueger from Nightmare on Elm Street, an absolute classic film, but in Call of Duty, he's not very fun to play as. He is the least favored in the cast, which naturally makes him the least favored amongst everybody that plays the game. He's not boring, but he's also not very exciting at all. He's just an old dude with a pitchfork, which is pretty badass, but beyond that, not very important. None of the Call of the Dead characters are very important. Call of the Dead played a very small role in the storyline, and after all, they are just celebrities. But Robert Englund just happened to be the least popular of all of them. Number 19, Sarah Michelle Gellar, whose most famous role is in Buffy the Vampire Slayer. She is the female badass of this crew. She doesn't use guns. She uses either her fists or a sickle or some sort of melee. Not a character you want to hear talking through the entire length of the game, but she is a fairly likable character. There is one concern I have with her, and that is her outfit. I mean, Jesus Christ, you're in the middle of Russia during winter time. What the fuck are you thinking? But she is a 10 out of 10 wood smash. Number 18, Michael Rooker, who I know best from The Walking Dead as Merle, who was the most badass character in that show, may I add. And he was also very badass in Call of the Dead. This guy's pretty hit or miss. You either really enjoy his voice like I do, or you just hate it. I can see why people might not like it. It sounds sort of raspy at times. The reason why I like him so much is because he is the perfect zombie slayer. He's down to earth. He's a normal guy, but he's also fucking badass. He's good with pretty much all guns. And although you may not actually care for him, I think he's one of the better characters in the game. Number 17, Danny Trejo, the machete guy. The Mexican machete guy. That's how everybody knows him. He is, like Michael Rooker, a complete badass. I mean, his most famous movie is literally called Machete. Like, it doesn't get any better than that. He has a plethora of funny quotes. He's a pretty enjoyable character to play as, and I think most people will agree he is an awesome guy in real life and in this, because he is actually a real person, just like every other Call of Duty character. Anyways, moving on. Now we're gonna hop into the Shadows of Evil crew at number 16, Floyd Campbell, the boxer, who is training for a giant fight that he is afraid he will lose. So he slips some brass knuckles under his gloves and kills a man. And that is why he is participating in Shadows of Evil. Floyd is sort of the meathead of this group. He's tough, he's willing to fight, and he's not very intelligent. Well, I shouldn't say that. He's just not very insightful. Floyd's got a unique voice. I like it. You may not, but Floyd, overall a pretty decent character. Number 15, Jessica Rose. Jessica is a dancer at the Black Lace Burlesque, which is a club downtown, but she aspires to become a Hollywood actor, and in order to do so, gets in a relationship with a film producer, which eventually gets uncovered by the press, and in order to hide the evidence, she kills her husband, and her sins, like all the other characters, lead her into Shadows of Evil. I don't mind her character too much. There's nothing bad in particular, but overall, she's not very exciting, and she's not a character that people are motivated to play as. She's just sort of there. It makes sense why she's there, and we're gonna move on now. Next up,
you know who I am? I'm Jackie fucking V!
We have the man who constantly reminds you what his name is, just in case you forgot, Jack Vincent, the police officer of Morgue City, who has dealings with mobsters and criminals of all sorts. His crooked nature would eventually lead to the city's mayor leading an investigation across the entire police department, and in order to not get arrested, this man killed all of the criminal associates to keep his name clean. Honestly, the reason why I put Jackie Vincent above the others is because he's more memeable, he is a little bit better, he's a little more badass in my opinion, and overall, he's a pretty good character, I'm not gonna lie. I love his style, I like that hat, that top hat. Oh! At number 13, we have Nero Blackstone, who was once a very successful magician, but for unknown reasons, has lost his popularity. He's married to a very demanding woman who has accumulated a lot of debt, so in order to pay off the debt, he kills her in a staged accident. Nero is definitely the most interesting of these four characters. For some reason, he has insight on the Cronorium and what's going on around, even though the other three characters are pretty much oblivious. And there's also lots of speculation that he made a deal with the devil to be all-knowing and all-powerful, so he could reclaim his position as the best magician in the world. Nero himself comes off as arrogant and quirky, but if you get past that and you listen to some of his quotes, he has a lot of interesting things to say. Plus, I love the voice actor, Jeff Goldblum, so that's a giant plus. Nero is definitely my favorite character of this cast. The Shadows of Evil crew, though not extremely significant, do add a good part to the storyline, and there are various ties between this map and Mob of the Dead. Next up, we have the cast of five, all of which were real people in a real place, the Pentagon in Washington, D.C., during the Cuban Missile Crisis. The least favorite of which, number 12, Robert McNamara, the Secretary of Defense under JFK. He drives the meeting between Fidel Castro and JFK to discuss the Cuban Missile Crisis and the dangers it may present to the U.S. and Cuba when a zombie outbreak occurs in the Pentagon. Fun fact, he's also heard on the radio within Revelations, where he sends out a final distress signal. He was actually the last survivor of the four of them. He was stuck in the janitor's closet before he died along with the rest of them. McNamara was a very intelligent guy, very serious as well, and when I play as him, I'm just fucking ready to play five. Even the least favorite character of this cast is a complete badass, which goes to show how awesome this crew really is. At number 11, we have Richard Nixon, who had just been defeated by JFK in the presidential election, but for some reason was still invited to the Pentagon in order to discuss. Nixon, in real life, would later become the president of the United States, and say what you want about him being the president, but in Call of Duty Zombies, he's a pretty good character, a little bit goofy and a little bit awkward, but he is funny nonetheless. He's also there to relieve some of the intensity between JFK and Castro, and he adds a really cool element to the map. Racking the top 10, we have Fidel Castro, who also played a very important role in the campaign along with JFK and McNamara. Like I said earlier, Castro was in the Pentagon on account of the Cuban Missile Crisis. He was the dictator of Cuba at the time, and his carelessness is juxtaposed nicely with McNamara's intensity, disregarding the things that Castro did in real life. life. The Call of Duty Zombies Castro was a very laid-back guy. He just kicked back, lit a cigar, and slayed some zombies until his eventual death. He's the only, if not one of the few, Hispanic characters in Zombies, and it's really cool to get some of that culture, I guess. And he's also a funny guy. At your number 9 spot, we have John F. Kennedy, the man himself, the United States President. Now, what a lot of people don't know is that JFK and a group of researchers working under the government were working with Element 115 quite a bit. So when the zombies outbreak occurred, he wasn't very surprised. In fact, he was prepared. He pulled out his arsenal of weapons and got to it. Unfortunately, like I said a couple times already, they died in the storyline. I'm fairly sure, if not correct me in the comments. But they put up a fight, and JFK is by far the favorite of this group. And why wouldn't he be? He is a great guy in real life. Unfortunately, he was assassinated, but he's also a great character in Call of Duty Zombies. The second best Zombies crew, the Mob of the Dead crew, with number 8 being Billy Handsome, the hitman under Sal DeLuca and his mob. Sent to Alcatraz under 116 counts of murder. Billy is the badass, Billy is the tough guy, and he takes shit from nobody. Killing is something that Billy is just naturally good at, and zombies are, of course, no exception. What else can I say? Total badass, not as important as the other three, which I'll get into right now. Up next, at number 7, we have Michael Finn O'Leary, who was sent to Alcatraz on 16 counts of gambling fraud. Though he doesn't have quite the resume that Billy has, he has killed before, and looks out for himself above everything else. He's also a pretty smart guy, but the reason why he's above Billy is because he is one of the two blood samples that Richtofen is carrying in the vials within Zetsubou no Shima, which is important for the storyline. He throws out a few good quotes here and there. Overall, just a very good character, no weaknesses in my opinion, just like all of the Mob of the Dead characters. Right above him at number 6, we have Salvatore DeLuca, aka Sal, who is the leader of the gang that Billy and he were a part of. He also happens to be the other blood sample that Richtofen carries within the vial. He's above Finn because he is the leader of the crew, and he's definitely the alpha personality. Like all the prisoners, he has a very deep backstory that if you really want to learn about, you could watch another video because this isn't a character analysis per se, but he is a very interesting character who throws out a few good quotes here and there. He's a badass, and I love playing as Sal. However, the best character in the crew is number 5, Albert Arlington, aka the Weasel, the con man. He makes up for his lack of physical strength with wit, and even devises the plan to escape Alcatraz via plane. The four prisoners collect the plane parts that have been stashed around the map in order to fly to freedom, but accidentally crash into the Golden Gate Bridge, where we pack a punch, which indicates that the plan has failed. And when the plan fails, the other three prisoners bring the Weasel up to the rooftop and brutally murder him, which continues the cycle. However, if the Weasel ends up killing the other three, the cycle is broken, and the Weasel gets to walk away a free man, which is why he stands out the most of the four of them. He's on his own. Though many may find him irritating, he is a very in-depth character with many impactful quotes. And that leaves us with four more available spots, which of course are going to the OG crew. And we'll make this relatively quick since you guys already know the top four anyways. Number 4, we have Takeo Masaki, the Japanese warrior that fought alongside Richtofen and the crew in his ultimate quest. Takeo 1.0 is a very unlikable character. His entire vocabulary consists of emperor and honor. Takeo 2.0 changes drastically. His personality becomes a lot more down to earth, and he's a lot more spiritual, and he becomes a lot more sympathetic and open to Richtofen. Takeo is a complete badass, and his weapon of choice is a katana, which is of course very pleasant to look at. And Takeo comes in at number 4. At your number 3 spot, we have the epitome of badass, Tank Dempsey, the US Marine, who is the stereotypical American that sort of just screams whatever comes to his head, but he is nonetheless a great, well-rounded character. His 1.0 version is a lot more primitive and one-dimensional, but the 2.0 Dempsey is a lot more complex and is more down-to-earth and spiritual, similarly to Takeo. I resonate the most with Dempsey because we're both American, and of all the personalities, I feel as though mine matches the best with his. Dempsey is just a fucking awesome character, and he's definitely one of my favorites. The second best Zombies character of all time is Nikolai Belensky, the drunken Soviet, that being the 1.0 version of him. Now, Nikolai is a complete idiot and a complete drunk, but he is the comic relief that Zombies desperately needs. He is absolutely hysterical, and the 2.0 version of Nikolai is a lot more serious, but he is still a badass, and he's still Nikolai, really. He's just dealing with a lot of internal conflicts and struggles, but the charisma and laughter that Nikolai offers simply makes him one of the best Zombies characters of all time. The single best Zombies character of all time, and the most important one as well, is easily, you guessed it, Dr. Edward Richtofen, who created not only the Wonderwaffe DG2 and the Monkey Bombs, but also teleportation. He blew up the moon, he blew up the Earth, he swapped souls with two different people, and he killed Dr. Maxis, and he raised an army of the undead. If that isn't enough, I don't know what is. This was as predictable as my upload schedule after I said it was going to improve. I know it feels like I skimmed over these last four characters, but we've been playing as them for so long, over so many years and so many maps, that we sort of know them pretty much entirely. There's not much explaining to be done, and if for some reason you do want to hear a bunch about it, I'm sure fucking Mr. Waffle Waffles or Mr. Dalek JD have a video about it. That is it, however. If you enjoyed this, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. I spent a lot of fucking time on this, so I would really appreciate you, because I appreciate you, and you know, leave a comment, of course, giving me your favorite character. I would love to know, but I gotta go, so I'll see you later. Peace the fuck out.